I want to appreciate every one of you that have subscribed to my YouTube channel. We're currently at 3,000 family members here on my YouTube channel, and I want to say a very big thank you for every one of you out there that have subscribed to this family here on YouTube. And also, I'll be doing a live question and answer section where you can ask me anything, and you can also share your thought or whatever challenges you're going through, you're facing, using VMix, OBS, Wirecast, or Streamlab as well, and we'll get it fixed also. And if you're having any challenges at all, I'll also use TeamView to get to your system, and also we'll solve the problem together, know what it is, and we can also fix it as well. It's me showing appreciation and saying a very big thank you to you guys. And date for that question and answer live section will also be announced. I'll keep you posted on that so that all of you that have subscribed to my YouTube channel can also see that as well. And if you haven't subscribed or just coming across this channel for the first time, remember to hit that red subscribe button below. Always turn on the notification bell when you subscribe, so you will always be notified whenever I drop new videos here on my YouTube channel. This video is actually a request that I got from one of my subscribers. He said I should show him how to display his scripture in lower third format on VMix. I actually did a video on this for OBS, so if you're an OBS user or you haven't watched that video, remember to click the link in the description below to watch that particular video on how you can also display your Bible in lower third format on OBS. But this one is for VMix to that particular request that he said I should show him how to display his Bible in lower third format on VMix. I'm also going to do a video on how you can also display your lyrics in lower third format on VMix using just Notepad. Okay, so don't miss that video. Hit that red subscribe button below so that you'll be notified whenever all these videos are dropping back to back here on my YouTube channel. And without any further ado, let me show you how to display your Bible in lower third format on Vimeo, so that the Bible will be displayed in lower third format to your projector, to your TV, or whichever way you are projecting it to, and also online as well, so that they can read along and see the preacher on the screen also. First thing you are going to do is to open your browser or whichever one you are making use of. Okay, so let's go to my computer screen now. Open your browser. I'm currently using Chrome, and this is it here. You can see the Bible Show software, the Google Drive link. I've also dropped it in the description below. Go ahead, click on that, and you will get straight to this page where you can be able to download the Bible Show software, which is what we'll be making use of in order to display our scripture in lower third format on VMix. Okay, and one of the beautiful things about this Bible Show software is it allows you to send your output via NDI, so you don't have to use any cable or anything. You can even use the same laptop to display. So now let's go ahead and download the Bible Show software. So I'm just going to click on the download button here, and don't worry, this file may contain virus, blah 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 blah, and click on the download button, and it's currently downloading the Bible Show software, which is what we're going to be making use of to display our scripture in lower third format. I'm just going to give it some seconds for it to download, say 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second, and our Bible Show software has finished downloading. Now once you've downloaded the Bible Show software, the next thing is for you to install it on your PC. I'm just going to minimize my browser, go over to my file explorer here, let me expand this over to download here and compress, and you can see the Bible Show software here, and I think I've downloaded it before, so I'm just going to open this one. You can see the Bible Show 5, and all those other files you're seeing here are the King James version. There are some of the Bible version that I also added on the file. Okay, so don't worry, I'm also going to show you how to download the Bible versions on Bible Show. Okay, so some other Bible version like NIV, GNT, so whichever one you're making use of, I'm also going to show you how to download them and install them on the Bible Show software, so don't be scared. Okay, so now let's go ahead and install this. Just click and right click and select run as administrator. It's very important. Okay, so select run as administrator, and this is it. Don't worry, it doesn't contain any virus at all, so just go ahead and install it here. And it's also 100% free, so this software is 100% free, so you're not paying a dime for it, you're not paying anything for it. Okay, run, don't worry, just minimize it, and then let's install the King James version as well. So we've installed in King James version also. Let me minimize this. Once you've installed the Bible Show software, go ahead and open your VMix software. Okay, so which is what I'm going to do right now. I'm just going to give our VMix software a moment for it to load. Okay, now our VMix software is fully up. Go ahead and open the template if you have any. Okay, So maybe your projecting template, or to where you install all your lower third and every other thing you are making use of. Okay, so and this is it up here. Now after this is up, minimize it and go ahead and open the Bible Show file software, as you can see right here. So our Bible Show software is up, and this is the reference page. Just close this, and this is it right here, you can see. Now how do you install more scriptures on the Bible Show software? It's very simple. Go over to here, you can see the Bible on this options tab here. This one you can see here, see themes, configure, preferences, and Bible. So click on Bible, click on Bible here, and you can see other versions of the Bible. You can see here other versions of the Bible, both the French, Arabic, Igbo, Yoruba, so whichever one you're making, African, so just name it, so you'll find all of them here. And this software is 100% free. Okay, for now, I don't know, maybe that might make it paid later, but for now it's 100% free, so you can use it if you want to Italian. So just search from here and you can download any version of the Bible you want as well. Okay, now after you've downloaded your Bible version, you can see right up here, Bible version, so it's going to appear here. Let me download one for you to show you as example. Let me look for NIV. Okay, so this is NIV here, 2011. Let's install it, and you can see downloading, and it has downloaded. You can see the NIV has appeared here along with the King James version. So I'm just going to untick it because I don't want to use both of them at the same time. Okay, so you can untick the one you want to use and untick the one you don't want to make use of. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and untick the NIV. And once you've installed your Bible versions, go over to Teams. You can see here, go over to Teams and click on this download button right here. So click on this download button right here, and once you're here on this Teams collections, click on it and select 6. So this is the Teams collection that comes with the lower third template. Okay, so just select 6 and you can see it, the lower third template right here. You see, just go ahead and click on download and install, and it's currently downloading. You can see it's currently downloading it, and it has installed it already. So just scroll down and you can see all the lower third templates here. Now let's bring in a scripture. I'm just going to go over to Leviticus, okay, 11 verse 30. And once you want to display your Bible, click on this play button. You can see this play button right here that you're seeing that is showing red. Just click on it, and that is it. You see, so select any lower third template you want to make use of. You see, and even select the big one if you want to use that. You can see, so whichever one you want to use, select that. And that is it. I've selected my lower third template here. You can select anyone you want to use. And once you've selected that, go over to configure. You can see the configure there beside the Teams. Go over to configure, you see destination there, untick the display windows and tick, untick that, untick the display window and tick the NDI. Okay, so tick the NDI and it will prompt you to allow access. Just also tick the private network and the public network and allow access as well. So I'm just going to wait for it. Okay, so once it's done, tick the NDI first and untick the display window. Okay, so I've unticked the display window. Can use it on the same PC, it doesn't consume much. You can use this Bible Show software on the same PC along with your main PC that you use to display your VMIS output to your projector or your screen. Okay, so it doesn't consume much of your CPU. Okay, so it's actually fine. So tick the NDI output and untick the display windows. Okay, so once you've done that, just go back to Teams, click, you see the scriptures here appearing. Okay, so just let's select another one, a more longer one, and that is it here. Let's minimize this and open our VMIS software. I'm just going to minimize this and go back to VMIS here. You can see this is it. Click on add input. Once you're on VMIS, add input here, click on add input and go over to NDI and desktop capture. Just give it a moment for it to load, and you see the Bible Show NDI. See, it's displaying here. Click on it and select OK, and that is your lower third scripture on the screen right there. So click any of the number 1, 2, 3, 4, and you can see our lower third scripture displaying right there. So I'm just going to bring in my webcam so you can see it. You can see that's me there, and that is the lower third scripture there. So if you want to shift it up a little bit, that's okay. You can just use this VMIS, double click on it here on VMIS. Was fast. Okay, so just double click on it here on VMIS and go over to position, and you can use this to move it. Okay, so move it up a little bit where you want it to be, and you can see that is the scripture right there. Okay, so you can use it, you can also display it, change some of the lower third if you don't like it. You can use another one, so whichever one you like is best known to you, and you can use that as well. So I'm just going to minimize this. minimize, push it down, and here you go. So whatever scripture you are displaying here, you can just scroll down. Whatever scripture is reading, you see as it's changing. So as you're changing it here, it's also changing on Vimix. You can see the beautiful effect there is also changing on Vimix. You can see right there. So it's also changing on Vimix. And if any part of their carcass fell upon any sowing seed which is to be sown, it shall be clean. You see, so this is it, and you can read it along. So this is it, and here is how to display your Bible in lower third format on Vimix. In case you love this video, consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. And once again, thanks to you guys, and also remember to give this video a thumbs up so the YouTube algorithm can also recommend it to other people who would want to be part of the family as well. Okay.